Imagine finally getting ready to launch your product and you flop hard and ruin your entire brand image because of a $2 part. It's not just possible, it happens more often than you'd think, even to the big guys. I'm about to reveal how a tiny, cheap component can bring down your entire product line and what you can do to protect yourself. In the world of product manufacturing, ideation, innovation, it's easy to get sidetracked thinking how your product will change the world and your life. People focus on the big picture only: marketing, design, distribution, and they do it so much that a tiny little wrench in the gears might even go unnoticed. And from what I've seen in the past 10 plus years, it's a lesson that many have to learn the hard way. Let me give you a real example. A few years ago, a major smartphone manufacturer had to recall millions of devices. Who was the culprit? A battery component worth less than a dollar. This tiny part led to phones catching fire, a massive PR nightmare, and potential billions in losses. Without going into too much detail and spilling the beans on our clients, people get nitpicky. They make penny-wise, pound-foolish decisions to save a bit here and save a bit there, not realizing that even if the product can work, how long will it work for? How will it stick up to the different elements that a customer will use their product in the real world? How can you QC for those things? Well, there's big companies that can manage, but startups more often than not can't. Outside of our customers, you see stuff like this in the news every day. I remember recently seeing a startup crumble because they tried to save a few cents on a crucial connector. A toy company that faced lawsuits because they cut corners on a small plastic part. Here's the thing. When you're looking at your bill of materials, it's tempting to try and shave off costs wherever you can. That $2 component, why not find one for $1.50 or even a buck? But what many don't realize is that this small savings can end up costing you everything. Cheap components can lead to higher failure rates, more returns, unhappy customers, and most importantly, in my opinion, a tarnished brand reputation. In today's world of social media, all it takes is one product failure going viral, and it can sink your entire brand overnight. So, how do you protect yourself? I can tell you that every component matters. There's no such thing as an unimportant part. Look beyond the price tag. Look at who you're working with. This is generic advice that I bet all the owners of failed ideas and ruined brands heard before making their big flops. Think about it. The truth is that experience is key. Where can you cut corners on costs and retain quality with the minimal possible risk of a major f*** up? Bleep that out. My answer is truthfully, never, or at least not now. And let me give you three reasons. Number one, you have plenty of time to worry about profit. You need revenue. You need to grow your business. You need to check and test the market to see if people actually want this. What's the point of saving a dollar if you make 10 fucking units? There's no point. You make no money either way. Point number one, you'll have time to worry about profit later. Number two is, it is in my experience that chumps negotiate for pennies. It is incredibly penny-wise and pound-foolish. There are so many things you can negotiate for. Negotiate on timelines. Negotiate on bumping up the packaging. Negotiate on quality control standards that must be met before the order gets shipped. Giving someone the price they want is one of the best things you can do in business. It makes them happy. It ensures they're going to work on your order and make it a top priority. The second you come in, and this goes again into the startup concept of running a business and manufacturing in China. Most people don't reach the MOQs, the minimum order quantities that factories want, so you're already starting behind the eight ball. How are you going to negotiate on prices when you're not even hitting the minimums that these factories are doing? Give them the price. Tell them, look, We're smart. We want to give you the price, but we're hoping we can do half the MOQ you're asking for. We're willing to keep that price up to a minimum order quantity of 3x your MOQ. And then once we start hitting those quantities, we'll be back to negotiate. That's music to anybody's ears. It helps the salespeople make better commission. It probably gets the engineers more pumped about the job. Definitely gets the boss more pumped. Going in and negotiating for pennies early on is just not a good foot to start on. So number two, don't be a chump. Negotiate about other things. Don't negotiate too hard on the price of a component. And number three, focus on growth. This is kind of a culmination of the other two points, but focus on growth. You have time to worry about those things later. Sell some product, then come back to the negotiation tables when you have a bit of leverage, you have a bit of momentum. Then people will be not only willing to talk about it, but they'll actually probably come down in price. Get there first. It's being able to constantly zoom in, look at the minute detail, and then zoom back out to see how it affects the big picture, and vice versa. It's a mental game that comes with experience. Zoom in, see if it matters. See if the 50 cents actually matter. I'm a big believer that you can charge your customers for your product if you make a good enough product. You make that money back. Pay people, like John Malkovich said in Rounders, pay Viet Minh his money. Maybe play the clip instead of me saying that. It's a mental game that comes with experience. Knowing what matters. Knowing if those prices actually make a project not feasible. I bet they don't. I bet you'll be just fine paying the extra 50 cents. Certainly at low quantities. Get up there and come back to the table when you're ready. Here's an actual piece of advice I can give you that you can take away. As I said, don't negotiate too hard on component prices. Don't negotiate too hard against your suppliers when your quantities don't justify that seat at the table. You're going to end up saving a bit of money today and losing a bunch of money by lack of interest from your supply chain, lack of priority, and ultimately poorly made products. It's going to cost you a lot more down the road. Spend that money. Spend more money. Invest in rigorous quality control and testing. Make sure that your products are what they are on your website. Make sure your products are what you say they are when you sell them. Yes, it costs more upfront. Almost all of the advice I have in this video does cost you more upfront, but it's a fraction of what you'd lose from a recall or a massively ruined reputation. Your product is only as strong as its weakest component. Sounds cliche, but it's true. If you treat it that way and don't rush things too much, you might just miss falling off a cliff somewhere during the process. I'll close with this. The next time you're tempted to cut costs on a small component or go back to your suppliers to negotiate that extra 5% that makes you a cunning businessman, remember, that $2 part could be the difference between success and failure. In manufacturing, as in life, it's often the littlest things that make the biggest difference. Choose wisely, and your product and your business will thank you. Post your questions in the comments below. Until next time, peace.